Welcome once again to another impromptu bowling video. Still haven't figured out the live streaming issue yet. Not sure if any recent phone updates have fixed it or not. So, still haven't gotten to that. Anyway, I'm actually out for a company outing, but I figure since I'm on vacation and it's kind of a waste to head all that way out, that I would make something of it. So I stopped here at Harvard Lanes, Harvard, Massachusetts, and bowl a couple hours here, or fill out the sheet, whichever comes first, and then head off to the outing, which should be around that time. So without further ado, and yes, I'm doing 720p, because it cuts it really, really close to maxing out the memory if I leave it at 1080. So after every frame, I do look at the thing, make sure it's running, in case we hit that 4 gig limit that usually happens. All right, enough yapping. Let's start watching me sucking. I hit my leg and I got that. And we start with an 8. That's how it's supposed to go. Another 8. It's pen and paper here, so it might be a bigger gap since we've been doing so many semi and fully automatic scoring places as of late. And a 7. Thank you. another 7. I keep forgetting, the microphone is more sensitive when it's in regular video recording mode than it is doing live streams. So also, apologies for the modulation. Just went right into the gutter, so it's an 8. It's now time for the halftime report. The worst we've done so far is a 7, and they do have a large fan running, so it's going to be hard to hold this. Bunch of 8s and a couple of 7s for a 38 so far. There's a mark. We call that one a strike. All right, we get 2 bonus balls, also known as El Stinko. Time for El Stinko, the bonus ball. 1. Because it's a strike, we get 2 of them. They both live up to their name, a 5 fill. And that's the curse of the fill, a 6. Thank you. a niner. Four points away from good, and for those of you that don't pay attention or just don't remember, I consider 70 to 79 all right, 80 to 89 good, considering who's doing this, 90 and up to be really good, 100 plus fantastic. And a 7. 6 was the worst I did in that frame. This one, we're walking away with one good game. And again, we gotta make sure. We got the strike in 6, and of course, El Stinko, the bonus balls, lived up to their name, only giving me 5. The 6 was the worst of it all, as I said. 8, 9, and 7 for a total of 83. If it weren't for a few more marks, that could have really been good. But I'll take 83. Game 2. But that droning noise, yeah, I think you can see what it is. And we're starting off better with a 9. And you know what a better start means, a worse finish. A spare. El Stinko, the bonus ball. And there you have it, a 1. Crappy 5. curse of a fill. Bowling gods must have woke up and realized I was playing. There's the first stink frame of three. It looks ugly, but supposedly that's an easy spare conversion. But look who's trying. And a nine. It's time for the halftime report. Start off well, then we got a spare, then El Stinko lives up to its name, and the curse of the fill took over for a couple of frames, and then we recovered with a nine. We're one behind the previous game at 37. Kingpin stands for a nine. Seven. That's a seven. And a 9. Need one pin to be in all right territory. That's a tough one. 4 horsemen left side and the 10. And for the final score, it didn't do too bad. A couple of mediocre 7s there. For a total of 77, considering the 5 and the 3 there. Time for game number 3. And it looks like the pin setter is deciding to give me all my balls back. Last time I was here, it would hold one hostage. And have to throw a bunch of balls down, knock some pins, mix everything up in a pin setter and get it back. All right, let's start game 3. Four horsemen protecting someone. If an errant ball goes off and there's wood, you never know, it could help you. And it did. That's a 7. Worst start so far, but I'll take that if that's my worst. And a 6. All right, we'll be back in a moment. There appears to be questionable wood on the deck, and no one's here. Okay. Yeah, that's fine.
If you want.
That's fine.
See, there's a line down there which you can't see.
I can't.
I've been going on it for 60 years, so I think I know where it is. There's light on half of it.
Yeah.
The thing is good. In fact, I'd bet you $1,000 to you up one penny. How's that sound?
I believe it.
You want to take the bet?
No, I believe it.
No, really. Serious.
I
wouldn't tell you if it was.
Shit.
when you can see the wood to play a shot, you play the wood. You don't play the dead wood. Unless you really have to.
Yeah.
This is what happens. You probably could have made the shot. You don't know, but.
Covering, so far this is the worst game. Frame of four. Considering how it started, seven's pretty good. Halftime report. So far, this is a crap game. The nine is the only thing that's really good there, for a total of 33. Minor lob, but let it live. It's a seven. Broken wing. Nine is pretty good for any spread eagle type formation there. Thank you. 8. You can pull into all right territory here. And a 7. Alrighty, to round out this one, it's an alright game. Not a good game, but an alright. Recovered at the end. Couple of alright 7s, bringing us to a 72, the worst game. And if that's my worst game, once again, I believe it. Alright, time to start number 4. There we go. We had to get a half Worcester eventually, and there we are. Now we start with a 7. It's middle finger for a 9. Thank you. right, the lightning for an 8. It's the kingpin that's standing for an eye. God's middle finger for a 9. And the way to tell the difference between the king pin and the head pin, which is the middle finger appears brighter. It's hard to tell in this thing. It's time for the halftime report. It's hard to tell because it's far away. So you can't tell the difference between a 1 and a 5, perhaps. Well, the 7's the worst thing so far, for a total of 42. Appears darker, if you can tell the difference. Never know how it comes out in recording. That's the kingpin again for another 9. Time bowling gods of 10. Spare. And because it's a spare, it's time for El Stinko, the bonus ball.
Yeah.
It's a four. Seven. We could hit great territory. Not banking on it, but it's possible. Well, ain't that a kick in the lower area? We gotta watch how we say things on YouTube now. Did pretty good. And then a couple mediocres. That is painful. 1 point away from great, but still, 89 is good. Even under ICBA standards for casual bowlers. Let's start game number five once I get the score sheet ready. Worcester left. Usually my half Worcesters are crap frames. That's a seven. I'll jinx it, but seven's the worst start so far. The dreaded high-low jack, which is the 1-7-10, as 10-pinners call it. There's wood, but ouch. Gotta try to cap the one in the middle. Forget the one on the left. Why not? An eight. Skip lumps are legal. Nine. stayed on for the 10. It's now time for the halftime report. So far, 7's the worst, and 10 is the best, bringing you a 40 thus far. Three pins away from all right. Left with the four horsemen left side, and many of my balls disappearing. War and Conquest down for our eight. Last frame, 5 points away from a good game. Wood for a 7. final statistics for this game. Again, the worst thing is a 7. And we got an 82. So let's see what game 6 has in store. Made an error. There's my worst start, a 5. And there's another stink frame. I haven't had one of those for a while. It's a 3. Gods woke up. It's a 4. And a 5. Left side. Finally, something decent. An 8. Yeah, this one's stinking. There's nothing good here except for the 8. Only a total of 25. Best we can do is 9. And got it. At least you don't have to worry about the low. We're tied with it at 44. Yeah, this is going to be a bad game. Two tens in a row. Nope. There was a 9 in between. It's possible to be a good game, but I'm not putting any money on it. And a spare. To wrap up this game, El Stinko, the bonus ball. Yeah, and that'll be it for game 6. Stinko does its job again with a 3. right. It was an all right game. Not a good one. You did all right there. Seven was the worst. Then, of course, the crap three fill on the spare, squeaking us into a good game of 74. And speaking of sevens, that happens to be the game. Legal ball. I don't like them, but they're legal. Start with an 8. Turn around and the left side disappears. Frames to go, or already beating the halfway point from the previous game. Actually tied. Just kiss that pin for an 8. Again. time report. All pretty good. Worst thing there is an 8 for a 41. A mark and a good fill would help. By a stink frame of 4. Which one should I aim for and miss? Barely missed it for an 8. It cut out. I got an 8 in that last frame. There's one to go, 3 points away from an alright game. Yeah, I haven't quite memorized where the stop point is at 720p. Two spray and pray didn't work. Still an 8. Alrighty. The final for game number 7. That 4 really stunk. And the 6 was bad. And the rest were 8s for a total of 75, which was the impossible-to-reach childhood score from way back when. Well, we're not children anymore. At least I'm not. All right, game 8. Once I get the sheet ready. 7 to start with. Wonderful five. Twice as good as the worst start so far. That's a new one. Perfectly normal thing that happens. Leaving the Woolworth for an 8. Halftime report. That lousy 5 did it in, but still, 37. Seven. frames lift tied the low of 44. I meant three frames left. That was frame 7 we finished. Yeah, this is frame 7. I'll get it right. Was the most unusual strike I ever got. I did not see that one coming. That means two. El Stinko, the bonus balls. Yeah. Definitely lived up to its name on crappy forefill. Again, not a good game, a 5. Again, being stung by the off by 1. Again, not a good game. That 5, that awful fill ruined it for the strike there. 79 total. 79 isn't 80. Therefore, it's not considered a good game. Got 4 more on the sheet. Let's fill them in. always start with a 10. Stink frame of 3. We're tied with the 8th game. Right, the lightning just barely stayed on for a 9. Are asleep for that errant ball. Still got the spare. Which brings us to the halftime report. That stink frame in number 3 there. Yeah. Then a 9 and a spare. So far, we've got a 39. We have not thrown El Stinko yet. It's time to throw El Stinko the bonus ball. See what we get for a bonus. El Stinko really lived up to its name there. Nothing. We got a Woolworth, which is the 5 and 10. And it remains for an 8. Thank you. spread eagle with prey. And that's how a spread eagle formation usually ends up. Bad. A five. Another wonderful find. A good game was possible, but no more. Again, we might hit all right territory. And a spare. Can do is 76. So all that's left now is El Stinko the bonus ball. Finally, a decent fill. Six. Bowling gods fell asleep, because this was supposed to not be a good game, and it wound up working. Yeah, those crap fives there, then a nine, then a spare with an actually halfway decent fill of six. Not the greatest, but still, I'll definitely take six. Leapfrogging into good territory with an 82. Three games to go. Thank you. No, this ain't the start. Yeah, too much going through my mind at the moment. Nothing bad, though. It's a 9. I guess in the beginning, I'm doing this before a company outing. I'm on vacation, so I'm doing this before I head there, so at least make it worthwhile. So I got that going through my head, because you know I do miniature golf there. You know, hoping the weather will hold up. It's not very promising. Anyway, let's continue this game. Four horsemen and a friend they're protecting. The four horsemen go, but their friend stays alive with a 9. Same scenario, side opposite. And a 6. Leary left, four horsemen and the 9. An 8. And just to repeat, those of you that play 10-pin, you call that the rail or the picket fence. It's called the four horsemen a candlepin because it is a lot harder to convert. And speaking of scoring, it's the halftime report. That 6 kind of wrecked it there, but still, we're at a 41. So close, but a 9. I take it the ball bounced off the back. Since it did not hit any legal wood or pins, that doesn't count. It's a 9 at best. Now, if the ball hit any legal wood before it bounced off the back wall, anything that happens is good. That'll be an 8. Doesn't this look familiar? Goalposts. Niner again. Just 3 pins away from all right territory, but 2 frames left. Five. There goes a chance for a good game. Actually, it's still there. I need 8. So of course we're not going to get it. It's a 5. Again, it's another kick in the lower regions that we can't say on YouTube now. 79 yet again. 1 point away from a good game. Sorry. Calls don't cut it. 2 to go. Bowling God's middle finger for a 9. That's gotta be wind related. I actually saw that ball not hit it. Hey, by ICBA standards, that still counts. It's perfectly standing. No foul ball hits it and it goes down on its own. While game's in progress, it still counts. Look it up. Seven with a little air assist. There's something on the pin plate over there. It's making them topple ridiculously easy. Well, I still counted that one against me initially, way back. No records broken or anything. Who cares? Anyway, it's a 9. It's ugly. We have to play wood on this one. Yeah, I know that. There's got to be some weird wind current going on back there. Still, if you look at the rules under ICBA rules, if a pin stands and is perfectly solid, then falls on its own, it still counts. It's in the rules. Speaking of scores, here's the halftime report. See, I did see that it did not foul out there. So far, the 7's the bad one, and the 10 with the weird wind current thing going on back there, bringing us to tie our low score of 44. That's what the little L represents, the low score or passing it. And since we're reaching that 4 gig moment, going to stop the video and come back with frame number 6 of game 11. This time it was a controlled stop. 6th frame of game 11, starting now. trainer and the bowling god really wants to let them know that he probably is watching. So an actual hit, it won't go down. Eight. Game is possible. We're at 72 to go. As Don Gillis would say, a strike. Last frame, two El Stinko bonus balls. And they live up to their name, a three. And denied from the 90s club yet again. Told you, even if it seems good, the bowling gods are watching. Another kick in the groin. I'm gonna say it. And it... The crappy three fill did it. Got an 89. Time to finish her up. Last game. Pin remains for a nine. looks like a spray and pray. We gotta aim it towards the 4-pin and hope the other one will take out the 10. Or do absolutely nothing and just spin there. Still an 8. For those wondering why did I not go for the head pin and other stuff on the third ball, unless it is going to actually help you, go for the points. Go for the cluster of points, not go for the glory. Seven. Alrighty, halftime report. So far the worst thing we have are sevens for a total of 39. pin took that last one down for a 9. Territory, possibility of good. We need 9 for that. And you know, every time I say that, I jinx it. Lock. I don't like where that wood is. Got it anyway for a 10. I'm glad to say, even though there's nothing spectacular, although a couple really good games that unfortunately were won away, and a couple of alright ones that were won away, there are no stinkers on this sheet. But before we get to all that, here we go. Worst thing was the 7. And we end with a 10, getting by a piece of wood for a total 81. So here's the review. 83. 77. 72, that's the worst one. Ouch. 89. 82. 74. 75. Ouch. 79. 82. Ouch. 79. Another denial. 89. And 81. And the ball return gave me all my 4 of my balls back, which didn't happen the last time I was here. Hey, that's a bonus. So that's this adventure of impromptu bowling. I hit the camera. Well, I'm going to be just like about 10, 15 minutes late for the start, which doesn't matter. Food is around 5 anyway. So that'll be it for impromptu, easy for me to say, bowling from Harvard Lanes in Harvard, Massachusetts. And this is Georgia551 saying, hope you enjoyed and have a good one.